Today, I am going to be replacing this hot water heater and replacing the lines that feed into it.
The reason that I'm doing this is because when I use a lot of hot water, black soot starts to come from the faucet. The black material is coming from the grated rubber on the inside of braided supply lines attached to the water heater. These type of supply lines have braided metal on the outside but are rubber on the inside. Over time, as hot water runs through these lines, the rubber can begin to degrade. And loose degrading rubber can come out of the faucets when hot water is being used. This is what's causing the black soot that's coming out of my faucet when hot water is being used. To stop this, we're going to replace these lines with stainless steel lines that have no rubber. There will be links in the description to these types of lines. And because the hot water heater is already 8 years old, and I'm already doing the work of changing out the lines, I'm going to get a new water heater installed while I'm at it, considering their life expectancy is only around 10 years anyway.
Alright, now I'm going to turn off the water heater circuit breaker. Alright, I need to shut off the water supply. And that should cut off the supply of cold water entering the tank. And now I need to drain the tank out. We're just going to use a garden hose. I'm going to put down a towel just in case there's a little bit of leaks. So I got the hose on, turned the drain. Make sure that when you open this up, you open it up all the way. The first time I did this, I only opened up partway and it was taking forever to drain. And I wasn't sure if something was wrong. It was just that I didn't open this all the way. Open up the pressure valve at the top to help it drain quicker. And it should, after a few minutes, drain this tank. Warm. So while the tank is draining, I'm going to unhook up the electrical, disconnect it. All right, and I should be good to remove these lines. These are shark bite fittings, and I don't want to use those anymore. Hopefully I can just use this to pop it off. And I'm just going to move on while it's draining to cleaning off these pipes now that I got the shark bite off.
I'm going to put some links in the description to the types of tools I'm using to clean and prepare the copper pipes.
Okay, now I got this one prepped. I'm going to remove the shark bite on this one and get this one prepped. Okay, hot water stopped coming from the back pipe on the hot water side. So I am going to clean off this pipe now. All right, now I'm going to prep for soldering. I'm going to put a new piece on here so I don't have to rely on the shark bites.
Depending on your water heater setup, you may already have threaded connectors available to easily replace your lines, in which case you wouldn't need to do any soldering. Also, if you don't feel comfortable soldering, there are alternatives, like using compression fittings like these. You can find these types of fittings that are easier to install in the installation kits linked in the description. For soldering the pipes, I'm just heating up the pipes real hot and then touching the solder to the heated up pipe all the way around to seal the pipe and the fitting.
Ready to try the other side now. Prep it with some flux. Okay, we'll let that cool for a bit. All right, the tank sounds and feels about empty now, so I am going to shut the valve back and undo the hose here. Let me put the towel in just in case we get a little drizzles.
Now we are going to remove the old tank with a hand cart to make room for the new one.
Oh, don't freaking tell me it's not gonna fit.
Make sure you carefully measure the space for your water heater, and not just the space that it's sitting in, but any passages it will need to get through to be placed. The first tank that I got had to be returned because the trim in the closet prevented it from slipping in, and it was only a half an inch larger than the original tank. Once you have a tank that fits in its spot, we can begin the process of hooking it up. The first thing that we can do is install the cold water supply line. We will prep the pipe fitting with plumber's tape around the threads of the fitting, and then twist on one end of our supply line. Then we'll prep the cold water inlet on the water tank and twist the other end over the nipple. Once we got the supply lines on, we will really want to tighten up the connections on both the water heater and on the pipes. I found that I had to tighten this down a lot tighter than I was comfortable with at first to stop any dripping. Then we'll repeat the same steps on the hot water side. Remember, as you're bending your stainless steel lines, to go slowly so you don't kink your lines. Once our lines are on, we can open up the water to fill the tank. Be sure to keep an eye open for any leaks. Now we can hook up the electrical. Start by connecting the ground wire to the green screw. Then twist together our two black wires and twist on a wire connector. Now we can twist together our other two wires and top it off with a twist-on wire connector as well. Then we can close up our electrical cover and tighten up our Romex connector. If your tank did not come with a pressure release valve pipe, you'll want to add one. I used a spare copper pipe and a compression fitting to make my pipe. Simply add the olive and tighten the nut over it. Now we can simply screw in our pressure relief pipe. The last step is to turn on the electrical from the circuit breaker back on. Give the tank an hour or so to heat up the water. Now we can test our hot water.
Soot.